subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to have an introduction to Boolean algebra. In our previous classes, we have clearly explained about logic gates. So all the logic gates like basic logic gates like AND or NOT, universal gates like NAND and NOR, and also the XOR gate and the XNOR gate has been clearly explained in our previous classes. We have taken nearly 10 to 15 videos and covered all the logic gates. And the concepts that are required for the logic gates has been already discussed. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire playlist so that you can have better insights of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now coming to this class, we'll try to have an introduction to Boolean algebra. So what is this Boolean algebra? Boolean algebra is a system of mathematical logic. As we have seen, our ordinary algebra is also a system of mathematical logic. Binary number system is also a system of mathematical logic. So in the same way, Boolean algebra is also a system of mathematical logic. So it is having its own mathematical logics, and Boolean algebra is governed by certain developed rules and laws. As we have discussed in our ordinary algebra, in our secondary school, we have understood, we have seen the concepts of algebra, where the algebra concepts will have its own set of rules and laws. Similarly, Boolean algebra will also have its own set of well-developed rules and laws. So the concepts of all the rules and the laws we will try to understand in our upcoming videos. Right now, we will try to have an introduction to Boolean algebra. So the same way in which the ordinary algebra is having its own laws and rules, Boolean algebra will also have its own laws and rules. So the algebraic rules are like commutative law, associative law, distributive law. So these are all the laws based upon which the entire concept of algebra has been developed. So the entire algebraic concepts were developed based upon these rules and laws. Similarly, Boolean algebra is also having its own rules and laws based upon this Boolean algebra. Its rules and laws, the Boolean algebra has been developed. Okay, now for example, if you take 1 plus 1 in Boolean algebra, so here in Boolean algebra, the plus symbol stands for OR operation. So the discussion about these concepts was already made in the logic gates concepts. So what is the output of this Boolean expression or Boolean function? So what is meant by Boolean function? Any complex logic statement can be expressed by a Boolean function. So if you take this logic statement, this logic statement can be expressed by a Boolean function. By using these operators, we can express a Boolean function. Okay, now what is the output of this Boolean function? This Boolean function is going to generate an output of 1. Similarly, if you take 1 plus 1 in all ordinary algebra, it is going to produce an output of 2. Similarly, if you take 1 plus 1 in the binary number system, it is going to produce an output of 1, 0. Okay. So like the algebra is having its own set of rules, ordinary algebra is having its own set of rules and laws. Similarly, the Boolean algebra is also having its own set of rules and laws. And any complex expression, you take any complex logic gate, it can be expressed by using the Boolean function. Okay, so what is this Boolean algebra, how those Boolean functions will get generated? So that we will try to understand clearly by using an example. So being an engineer, you are asked to design a circuit. So this is a cricket stadium, so don't worry about this diagram. So this is a cricket stadium, and in this cricket stadium we are having two big lights. So these lights, so in order to on these lights, the conditions are, So in order to on these lights, because these lights will be very costly, in the sense these lights are going to take lot of power. So nobody, anyone cannot be simply on switch on these lights. So there should be some purpose to on these lights, you know, to decide that whether the game is purposeful or not, whether to play in this cricket stadium at the night is purposeful or not. It is decided by some of the people in the administration. So in the administration we have CEO, CFO, CAO and manager. So from these four persons, there is certain logic to switch on these lights. So what that logic is, we should have either the permission from A, so either the CEO has to permit, or CFO is represented by B, and CAO is represented by C. These are the next level of administration. Either we should have the permission of both these people, either CEO has to approve, or CFO and CAO has to approve, or CEO, CFO and CAO has to approve. So if you have the permission from all the three, then also it's okay. Or you should have a permission from either CEO, or you should have the permission from both CFO and CAO. Okay, so all these conditions, if you satisfy these permissions, then only you are capable of switching on these lights. And these are the offices, and the switches will be present in each and every office, but the lights will on only when this the switch in this office is on, or the switches in both these offices are on. Are you able to get that point? That point is very, very important. So what is the logic is, if this switch is on, then the lights will on. If the both the switches in this office will on, then only the lights will be on. Or if all these three are on, then also the lights will on. So now you are asked to design a circuit, electronic circuit, so that these conditions will get satisfied. How you are going to develop this? So for this, we have to generate a Boolean function. So what this Boolean function is, it is based upon Boolean algebra. So what are the conditions? A should be on, and so which means it is an AND gate, A dot 1 plus B and C. If you got the permission from B and C, so if both, B means this is CFO's office, C means it is CAO office. So if both these switches are on, this is an AND operation. So AND operation happens to be 1. 1 means the lights will become on. When the lights will be on? When? So don't worry about this dot 1 right away. So we will try to discuss in the circuit design. So if A switch is on, if the switch of A is on, or if the switches in B and C offices are on, so this is the symbol for OR operator. So the discussion about logic gates has been done. And if B and C are on, so what is the AND operator? When the 1 will be produced, the 1 will be produced for AND operator, AND gate, only when both the inputs are on. So that is the logic gate, right? So whenever both these operators, whenever both these variables are on, whenever both the switches are on in these two offices, then the lights will be on. Or if A is true, if A is true means whenever the switch in A is on, then also the lights will be on. Okay. Or if all the switches are on, then also the lights will be on. Now this is what we call it as a Boolean function, and this is what we call it as Boolean algebra. So B and C will become produce an output of 1 whenever both the inputs are on. Okay, so now we have to create the circuit for this. How the circuit can be created? So this is an AND gate with the combination of 1. As we have said that AND gates are 2 input AND gates. So we are going to take one input as A and another input as 1. So why we have taken this 1? We will discuss about this later. So this is what we call it as a law in the Boolean algebra. So what happens with this? So we'll try to understand a bit about this. So what happens with this is we are trying to produce the output which is there at A. So what is the output of this is A dot 1 is equal to A, which means that whatever that is there at A, it is going to get produced, it is going to be produced as the output, and this one is permanently fixed to 1. So what it is going to be is, for example, if it is 0 dot 1, what is the output of 0 dot 1? It is going to be a 0, so it is equal to A. Similarly, if you take 1 dot 1, A is equal to 1, 1 dot 1 is going to produce an output of 1, AND operation. So you should be familiar with the previous videos. So if not, please watch those videos and come back here. Okay, so it is going to be an A. And the next circuit, the next logic gate that we have to take is a AND gate, and this AND gate has to be the inputs of B and C. If this is, and these two AND gates are to be connected to an OR gate. See here, this is the circuit for this system. So if you are given with a task like this, this is the circuit that you have to connect. So it is going to produce an output of 1. It is going to produce, this circuit is going to produce an output of 1. Output of 1 means the power will get transmitted to these lights. The power will be transmitted to these lights only when the circuit produces an output of 1. When it is going to produce an output of 1, so this is a 4 input combination. So we have taken A, B, C, M. We have 4 inputs, in the sense 4 variables, A, B, C and M stands for manager. So the manager will also have a switch for this, but it will not, these lights will not on if the manager switch is switched on. Okay, so it is these lights will on only when A is 1 or BC is 1. So this one is a true condition, and also 0, 1, 1, it is also true, and here 1 is this and this one is true. Or are there any possibilities? So there are no such possibilities. So whenever A is 1, so these combinations will be true, and these combinations will be true, and these combinations will be true. So when these switches will be on, so how many combinations are there? So this is the first one where B and C are true. This is the place where, this is the input combination where we can produce an output of 1, which means there is a permission to switch on these lights. And other one is, this is the combination where B and C is 1. So this one is also going to produce an output of 1. So is it going to produce an output of 1? Yes, it is going to produce an output of 1, because A is true. So the condition is, if A is true or BC is true, or means if any one of its is true, then it is going to produce an output of 1. So the logic gate OR, so that is what this OR is. So if it is having any one of the output as 1, if it is having any one of the input as 1, it is going to produce as output of 1. So when this OR gate is going to be true, it is true for all these conditions. So for all these conditions, it is going to produce an output of 1. So this one is also true because A is true. Because A is true means this is one of the logic. And for all these values, this one is going to be true. And if you check these two conditions, these two combinations, so here all the ABC values are true. ABC values are true. So we are nowhere worried about 1. So whether the switch is on or off, we are not at all worried about this M, because it is not our concern. Our concern is to satisfy the conditions where the switch at A is on or the switches at BC or on. That is the rule. Okay, so based upon that rule, we have developed this function. From this function, we have developed this circuit. So this is how the Boolean algebra will help in creating the Boolean functions, and the Boolean functions will get converted into circuits. So the entire concepts of digital logic design is to design these circuits based upon these Boolean expressions or Boolean functions. So this point is very, very important to understand. So I am going to give a small task for you. So here we have changed the condition. So the condition is, if A is on, then only the power has to be on, or BC is on, then only the power has to on. So if A and BC, if all the three are on, the switch should not be on. The light should not, so the lights in the ground should not be on. So here, if all the three are on, then the lights has to off. So how you are going to design the circuit? So by simply changing one gate, we are going to convert this circuit. So what I am trying to make you understand is, the question is, the lights has to on only if A is on or BC is on. If all ABC are on, then the light should be off. So we have changed the condition a little bit. Now by changing one gate from this, you can satisfy this condition. So if this is the value, so it should not, the switches should, the light should not on. But in our previous condition, it is going to, the lights will on if all these values are true. If all the switches are on in A, B, C offices, then also the lights will on. But now in the new condition, if all the switches are on at A's office, B's and C's office, then the light should be off. Any one of the condition has to be satisfied. Only any one of the condition has to be satisfied. So how to design the circuit? So which one has to be changed to which gate? So you try to give the answer in the comment section below. You try to just give the answer, which circuit has to be, which gate has to be replaced with which gate. Just give the answer. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding these concepts, please post your doubts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.